I get Maurizio and Steve working on a coffin frame. And you know, it's not easy because you gotta make the top part open. So you gotta have a hinge and it's gotta be just right.
Now we're good. Oh yeah.
And I get Ralph started on a Danny lookalike. Betty wanted the blood to come out of the cake when you cut into it, but I thought it would be better to have the blood come out of the bite holes because, I mean, at the end of the day, it's for a bunch of vampires, right?
Hey, Mauro. You're looking.
The hell are those things on his head?
He's got those things. All right, I know maybe it doesn't look like Danny right now, but look at this. Not Danny, Danny.
For this cake, we're gonna use red velvet cake with vanilla buttercream that we added red food coloring to.
I feel like a mortician.
With the cake part done, we start by painting this coffin a nice wood grain. We'll also add some gold details, and I got Juan and Tyne making different creatures to put on the outside of this coffin.
You like it?
He looks very peaceful. He looked like he didn't put up a fight. He just died for the vampires.
Ralph was very generous with your hair.
I was.
I'm just saying.
Then, we just have to get our dearly departed Danny inside.
Whoa. Man, he just threw you in.
We add the tubing so that we can make the blood come out of the vampire bites on Danny's neck. We add a little material for the coffin. And there you have it, a cake fit for a vampire.
Hey, Ralph.
Hey, bud.
I just had a consultation.
Okay.
With your friends. They were talking about a little thing that you go to, live action role play. LARPing.
Awesome.
You wanna talk about it?
No, I was really hoping that was something that I would just never have to talk about here.
There's nothing to be ashamed of. You're a big nerd. I get it.
I'm excited about doing a cake.
They want us to do a thing called a griffin.
Okay, it's like a half lion, half eagle.
Okay, so what I'm thinking is this is one of the cakes that we can go a little bit over the top with.
So like we do it maybe like we can have the wings coming out.
Yeah. Animal cakes are always fun for us. The textures, the feathers, the details. So I'm gonna let Ralph go in the wood shop and build the board. Kind of get the skeleton together for this griffin cake. So I'll let Chad make the filling, because he's kind of like our pastry nerd. Chad's doing a smoked chocolate filling, and it's got chocolate granola for crunch.
That's where loving is.
So now that we got the structure in place, then we're gonna build the cake around it. We're using plain vanilla cake. We got Chad's smoked chocolate filling.
Put the crunch on it.
That's good, that's high enough. We'll stop it there.
So now we gotta carve the shape of the griffin, you know, the lion portion.
Just get a little junk in that trunk there, Griff.
This cake is starting to come together.
What do you think a griffin tastes like?
Pigeon.
The griffin cake we're making for Ralph's LARP friends is really starting to come together.
Squawk.
Ah, it looks awesome. We're making the lion legs out of crispy treats and modeling chocolate.
I like it.
Ralph is sculpting the eagle head. Ah! Ralph, when it comes to sculptures, I mean, he's the man. This is what Ralph does best, and it's for his LARPers, so he's really gonna go nuts. So my idea for this cake is a big, jacked version of Wari. Like, through the cake. Ralph with sculpted muscles, tones, and physique, that's his bag, baby. Then my plan is to build a cake base around the sculpture. And we're gonna put all the flavors that she wants, every one of them. Because if Lori don't like this cake, she's gonna come after me. She's got some big guns, baby.
That's what I'm talking about. That's what that should be.
At the end of the day, Ralph sculpting the body, his biggest challenge is gonna be proportion. You know, getting it to not look too masculine and really capture the beauty of what Lori is.
But can I just tell you something? This looks like a man.
We were kind of having fun with it, and we were gonna make her like a giant She-Hulk.
I I appreciate the fact that Ralph exaggerates things, you know, but in this case, he made her too big. Guy bodybuilders, they just want to get jacked and ripped as big as they possibly can. Girls are really trying to do sculpting, so they kind of take offense if they're done too big.
She's gonna hate you.
Come on, Lisa. You're not helping at all.
Sorry.
I don't want Lori to see this cake and think that, you know, we think that she's the Hulk.
It's not right. It's not right.
So Ralph gets the body a little bit more shaved down. Something a little less She-Hulk and a little something that looks more like Lori. Now it's time to put on the skin.
Yeah, I mean, I guess rhinestone and velour isn't really, you know, active wear for the water, but still. All right, Alex, we got a bunch of shiny rocks.
Let's get bags. Let's start bagging it out. Let's fill it up. So for the filling, you name it, bada bing, it's gonna have it all. I finish the cake, I step back and I look at it, and I'm just looking at it like where I really want to capture more feminine and beauty than power. So I want to add some more girly elements that's going to make it look pretty. I just thought that, you know, having a little bit of like a red sash or drape is going to be a little more feminine, a little bit more girly.
Just bling it and be done.
I go with red roses because I feel like it's really gonna match all the colors on there. Because, you know, what's more girly than a flower?
These are nice. I think we got it. What do you think?
Yeah, I think you nailed it.